Hi Carnivore fans, it's Holly and I'm back with an update. It's been 6 weeks on the carnivore diet now and I'm feeling good. My commitment is high. You know, I'm not wavering in my commitment to doing the carnivore diet, but that doesn't mean it's easy. And it's actually not so difficult doing the diet. It's just that, you know, I'm not feeling all that great. I'm feeling fatigued. I'm not sleeping well. I'm still looking to get a lot of the results that I want out of this. But I am feeling better than I was before I started this. I mean, I just felt so bad. I just felt like crap before I started this. And I've told you my story before, but basically I've done a lot of dieting, starting in adolescence, a lot of low-fat dieting, calorie counting or just weighing my food or intermittent fasting, or, you know, even though I'm doing paleo and eating really healthy, and I've been doing high protein, but I have not been doing high fat. I've been doing low fat for years and years and years. And it just culminated in this reaction that I get, and it's extreme hunger attacks. And it happens when I'm, you know, it happens when I'm undernourished. So even though I'm eating paleo, but I'm not eating enough fat. And especially if I'm traveling, maybe I'm not hydrated enough, maybe my meals are off, my time schedule's off. Anyway, I just get these attacks. And it's been building and building and building over the last year, especially the last few months, have just been unmanageable. Like, I couldn't work, I couldn't focus, I couldn't do projects. I can't sleep at night because I'm up at eating at 1, 2, 3 in the morning. And that's settling down. Like, now I can go through the day and just have 3 nice, good, heavy meals, with carnivore meals with fatty meat. I'm doing high fat carnivore, so I'm adding extra fats on top, like butter, which is very nice, very flavorful, and really very easy to do. So it's not that the carnivore diet has been hard to do. It's really not. And it's just that, you know, I'm fatigued. I have low energy. I'm still not that motivated to do projects, clean the house, sort the mail, just all, you know, it was the holidays and that takes a lot of preparation. And I just don't have the same ambition for my own personal projects that I used to have prior to getting so sick this year. So it's not that the carnivore diet has created this lack of ambition. It's that I was so sick, I just lost it all. I lost the, like, if someone has chronic fatigue or fibromyalgia or autoimmune, they just cannot function. And even though you see them out and about for an hour or two in the middle of the day, that is not a reflection of how they're doing all day long, morning, noon, night. And that's how I was. Maybe I could squeeze out a few good hours and socialize and see people and get something done. But overall, my life was just dysfunctional. So in that respect, yeah, I am doing better. I'm feeling better. I feel like I'm making progress in the right direction that I want to be going in. So I thought today for my update, I would just take you on a little tour of my kitchen and kind of discuss the things that I was doing before I started carnivore diet and how that's all changed. A lot has changed. The cupboard has changed. The kitchen has changed. The refrigerator has changed. The stovetop, the cooking, the pans, like, everything's changed. It's all different. So, and I'm still learning and I'm still trying to develop new routines. So let's go see what's going on in my kitchen. So, all right. So let's see if I need to maybe turn this camera around so you can see. I guess. How's that? Yeah, you can see what's going on, right? Okay. So this is, we kind of have his and hers cupboards. Not totally, but, you know, his side, he's got all the carbs he's doing. He's an athlete. He does rice and oatmeal and buckwheat and nuts. Anyway, he does a lot. But me, well, what I used to do here, I used to have a bunch of almonds. I used to have natural hemp seed for some smoothies. I used to have, these are, noodles. These are like low carb noodles, coconut, stevia. I don't hardly ever use this stuff, but I had stevia and vanilla, cocoa powder, well, Himalayan sea salt, always been a fan of that. Here's my stack of organic, locally made Theo chocolates. They're right down the street. They have a factory right down the street. So, you know, I have a little stash of that there. And, okay, mung beans, that's sprouted beans. I'm not a big bean person, but, oh, goji. Here's all my superfoods, right? Goji. And this is nice. This is wild salmon, sockeye salmon, ready to eat. So, you know, I was fairly healthy. I was very definitely low carb. Yeah, I haven't even been in this cupboard since I started the carnivore diet. So let's close the door on that. Up here, I have just a whole bunch of tea. And I still drink tea. I'm doing, this is really nice at night, chrysanthemum tea. I have a sleepy time, nighty-night tea. I have ginger tea. I have yogi tea. These are all my night, oh, detox. Yeah, I'm still doing tea because, you know why? Because carnivore is a big change. And just to eat meat and not to eat any vegetables or salad or anything, I'm still having coffee, I'm still having tea, and I need that, something warm at night. I also will just boil some hot water and sip on hot water at night, which is also very nice, but I'm just not going 100% cold turkey on the carnivore quite yet. So, walking over here, here's the fridge. First of all, before we look at the fridge, let's look at the freezer. Because the freezer says it all. So, this, let's see what you can see in here. We have some raw shrimp, which is very nice. And I've got, we just stocked up. I had really nothing in here, but we got venison patties, ground lamb, ground elk, ground venison, ground beef. Down below there, we've got some steaks. I've got, steaks down there. So ribeye steaks. Freezer section. Fridge, not so much. Here's what's going on here. Again, his and hers, if you can see, his and hers. His, bunch of vegetables, vegetable broth. I drank my bone broth, that's gone. This is hers, this is his, all those vegetables in there. This is hers, okay, carnivore. So, I ate all my ground beef and what I have left in here, lamb, ribeye, this is another lamb steak, so this is all good. There's my bison. Let me tell you what's going on here is that because I'm eating the three meals a day, plus I'm eating at night, and I go through this food so fast. I stock this up, I fill this up, a pound of ground beef and a pound of ground lamb. I just go through it faster than you can even imagine. I'm out of bacon. I'm out of eggs. okay, so what is here? This is some liver that I decided I'm not going to try yet. I never liked liver. I did find a recipe where you can make this. You hardly even cook it at all. Just a little bit sautéed in butter. And it's supposed to be better uncooked. But I just haven't been brave enough to try that yet. Here's some cheese. I don't usually do a lot of cheese, but it's been the holidays, and, you know, it's nice to have a little bit of flavor, and I have been doing a little bit of cheese. This is blue cheese. This is Parmesan. I had some brie. I put the brie on the pork, and the pork, I'm tired of pork anyway. Brie and pork don't go together. Don't try this at home. This is the Cocoa Bliss, and this has gotten me through, this has really gotten me through, you can see it, there you go. This has really gotten me through several difficult nights. Like I said, I'm having tea, I'm having coffee, and I have had this Cocoa Bliss. It's sugar-free, it's really high grade, it's ceremonial grade cacao superfood cocoa. And I've had that a few times, 3-4 times in 6 weeks. So that's been nice. this. Let's open this up. What's in here? What's this little treasure box? Look at that. Oh my gosh. These are my butter bites. So I learned how to make butter bites. The first batch I had to throw out. They weren't any good. These are fun. I got a little mold and I just, you saute the butter, get it all nice and hot, get those milk solids browned. It's called brown butter. And I put them in the molds and they make little decorations and I thought they're really sweet. They're cute. I've been snacking on those. Makes a nice addition. So that's my fridge. Oh, the hot sauce, you guys, the hot sauce. Let's not skip the hot sauce. Frank's Red Hot is the antidote to hot wings. Red Hot and butter, that's the original recipe. There's nothing in here but just peppers. But this is the favorite. This is my favorite, Cholula. If you haven't tried Cholula hot sauce, well, I don't want to tempt you if you're a pure carnivore and you don't do this stuff, but for me, the hot sauce has been a lifesaver. It just has added some flavor, some variety. Sometimes I just put a little bit on my meat. I mix it with butter. Maybe I'll make a burger and put some cheese and put the hot sauce and the butter. It's been good. It's been nice. It adds variety and flavor, which I like. It's good taste. All right, here we are at the stove. Well, not much to say here, except, well, you can see here we have our bacon grease, which I don't, you know, I save it. When I cook bacon, it puts out so much grease that I got to pour it out somewhere. And that's where it goes. And then in the oven, I have now my cast iron skillets. I'm using two, a deep dish and a small dish, a thin dish, two cast iron skillets. I just keep them in the oven, put a little, you know, once I cook on them, I put a little water in there, hot water, stir it up, scrape it out, put them back in a hot oven so they dry completely and they don't rust. But I'm telling you, this has been the easiest thing. They go under the broiler. I put it on the high rack and put the broiler on low, and that has worked. It's taken me a bit to figure out what, you know, the high was too high, the low rack was too low, but the high, you can't put it anywhere. You can't put it on this top rack and then put the broiler on high. It took me a long time to figure out, okay, what's going to work for a steak or a burger or even now bacon. I do my bacon up here on a nice tray. I've got a big, nice tray that holds a good, you know, 6 pieces of bacon on that. And then I'll just scramble up some eggs and put it right in the cast iron skillet. That cast iron skillet also goes right on the stove. And we have an induction stove. It's the magnetic. It's the magnetic, heats up really fast, cooks really fast, and it only works with certain metals. Not every kind of pot or pan can take this kind of stove, but the cast iron works on that, so that's really nice. Oh, here's my little oven mitt. So when you're working in a hot oven, I got the little one, he's so cute. And I also got the big one, so let's go say hi. All right, well, we're having fun. So, you know, that's pretty much it. But there's 3 things that I want to say. There's 3 things. The first one is that it's just hard to keep my fridge stocked. It has been just hard to keep this puppy full here because I eat at night. And I'm awake at night. I'm hungry at night. I'm eating at night. Whatever I plan for breakfast the next day, I eat it at midnight, 1, 2 in the morning. So it's been very difficult. I've really had to change up what I'm doing. In fact, I can tell you after 6 weeks that now I like having bacon and eggs for breakfast. I just can't handle ground beef like a burger patty. It's just too much. You know, I used to eat turkey burger for breakfast, and that's nice and light. And I would have it with zucchini, maybe some berries. Nice and light, but heavy duty ground beef with butter on top, it's just too much. But bacon and eggs in the morning, that's nice. And, okay, 2 other problems. 2 more problems. So one has been this bacon grease. It's just been a lot of grease. And, you know, I did have to figure out how to store it. I've got a nice, elegant container coming on the way. But this one works. But the main point is that there's just so much grease going down the kitchen drain. You know, we've got to wash the dishes and We're just afraid. We've had to snake this sink a couple times and we don't want to snake it again. So here's what we decided. Decided that we've got these handy dandy paper towels, and after you cook, you just wipe up the grease with the paper towel, put it in the compost, and it's gone. It's done. So let's make sure you can see all that right there. Anyway, that has been the system that has worked, is the paper towels and the compost. And that's problem number two. Now, problem number three has been literally the broiler. It's just been too much smoke to making all my, you know, maybe we used to cook a steak once every couple weeks at the most. And usually at stovetop cooking, a lot of salads. Sometimes we don't even have hot food. But all of a sudden, when you turn this broiler on, even with the fan, it's been making so much smoke. And as you can see, our kitchen is really deep. And the stove is just really, really far away from the windows. So even with the window open, it just fills up this kitchen with smoke. It's a long, skinny kitchen. And it just hasn't worked very well. So the smoke and the grease, I will say, those are issues that we've had to figure out a system to solve. And I think I've got it down by never turning the broiler on high. Just keep it on low, keep the food up close to it, and that's working out. I don't really saute on the stove anymore because of that. I used to do that a lot, but like I said, I was cooking low-fat chicken or turkey, ground chicken, ground turkey. It doesn't put off a lot of smoke and grease and fat. So it's carnivore is different. Carnivore is different because you're eating these high-fat meats. And I like them rare in the center, but I sure like them sauteed and crispy on the outside. That's really nice. It's delicious, delicious, delicious food. I'm very much enjoying the food. And it's just these cooking techniques and what it's doing to our kitchen. And, you know, we're a little bit worried about the grease content going down the drain over time. So we're trying to take some preventative measures. But, you know, overall, carnivore is working. I'm happy with it. I'm doing better. I have a ways to go. This is not an overnight fix. Fortunately, I am reading more and more. I'm listening to more and more experts. I'm listening to especially Dr. Elizabeth Bright and Rebecca Heishman, Dr. Anthony Chafee, Dr. Ken Berry, Dr. Kiltz. Like these people, Dr. Sean Baker, these people have been doing this carnivore diet a long time. They are medical experts. They can answer all your questions, whatever would be holding you back, whatever concerns you have, whatever personal issues. There's coaching available. You can get medical appointments with some of these providers. And plus, the hundreds and thousands of anecdotes and testimonials, people's experiences. You know, what they like to say on some of these videos is, all these people who are doing vegan diet, where are their testimonials that their health has improved, their mental health, their physical health, their strength, their stamina, their energy? There just aren't those kind of videos among the vegan community. But when you look at the carnivore community, it's person after person after person has these testimonials about how well they're doing, how physically they feel better, more energy, weight loss, depression. All of these issues are healing. Their cravings go away. They're able to eat less. So that's what I'm looking for. And it's not happening overnight. And it's okay. I'm committed to seeing this through. Originally, when I started, I didn't know how long I would do it. But I knew I would do it a couple months, 2-3 months at least. And then now, the more that I'm looking at this, I'm sure it's going to take 6 months before I will know if I can achieve the results that I want out of this. And so here I am 6 weeks in, and I've got 6 months to go before I make a decision about whether this is really the right thing for me or not. But I feel healthy, and I decided to get some blood work along the way, some check-in at 3 months and a check-in at 6 months, and to monitor how I'm doing, how my health is doing, and my progress. And that's great. Information is great. So we're gonna keep going. We're living the carnivore lifestyle, and happy to be here. Bye.